Hey everyone, Flutter June here with a video teaching you how to make health apps in Flutter. In this 2-hour session, I introduced Flutter, created visualizations of lab data, and then connected everything to the cloud via Firebase. I've cut this session into smaller parts and put the timestamps in the descriptions to make this easier for you to get to where you want. This code is available on GitHub. If you like this session or this format, just let me know and I'll make more videos. And with that, let's get started.
Hi, people that are physically present and also that are over in Texas. My name is John Manning. I'm a physician at Atrium Health. I'm double boarded in emergency medicine and clinical informatics. And over the next 2 hours, I'm going to teach people here and remotely how to make apps with Flutter. I do have a disclosure because I co-founded a company called Mayjune, where we focus on user-centered designs and specifically use Flutter. But primarily my role is at Atrium Health. Atrium is one of the larger nonprofits in the country, nonprofit health systems. They have 50 hospitals spanning 3 states right now, North and South Carolina and Georgia. I'm at one of the main centers in Charlotte, North Carolina, Carolina's Medical Center in the Department of Emergency Medicine. I teach medical students and residents, and I do informatics things within our department. I'm also active nationally, both with ASEP on the emergency medicine, doing informatics and innovation-based things, and also with EMEA. And I've made some presented on Flutter for them as well. For those who work with me clinically here, if you ever see my badge, has 2 little pins. And one of them is also what I'm wearing today, Pinksocks. Wonderful movement. If you haven't heard it, you should. It's a TED Talk that's wonderful and it's a really good way to understand each person's story. But the other pin that I carry with me is a bird called Dash. That is the official logo for Dart, which is the programming language we're going to use today. All of the code that we have here will be available on my GitHub. It's already posted. github.com/firejune. And for those of us who are informaticians and questioning, is the fire an actual pun of fast health interoperability resources? No, it's not fire. It predates that. So got some fun hobbies over the years. Okay. So about you all, this just to break the fourth wall a little bit. At least of the people that are here in person, remotely, electronic, it should be very broad in terms of clinical, technical, and all variations therein. I believe the metadata that you've got right here, is there anybody else or any other perspective that I'm missing? And I know clinical, I'm also including pharmacy. Is there anyone else I'm missing here? This is probably one of the broader audiences I've ever tried to do a live coding with, so bear with me for those with more clinical and those with more technical backgrounds. Most of this lecture will be given as an in-person or a real-time live coding session from scratch, but I will start with some slides and I'll show you how to look some things up. And keep in mind that this is also being recorded for people who are interested in viewing this asynchronously. And if there's, you know, a question that you have or things like that, certainly you're able and encouraged to look this stuff up. I don't expect everybody to understand what this is for those that are in a computer science course or as students, but at least for the clinical, does this jump out as something that you see with frequency? Yes, what is it? It's a fishbone diagram for what specifically? A lab? BMP, basic metabolic panel, and this is what? CBC, great. I don't expect everybody to understand that just as much as I don't expect you to know every single lab that fits within this fishbone diagram, just as much as I don't expect everybody to see and immediately understand hello world or for or while loops. And as we start getting to the points of constructors and anonymous functions and things along those lines, I really want to take for some of the people that are in the room, the broader picture. Everyone here can drive a car, but you do not have to understand the, you know, internal combustion, pistons, starters. You don't have to understand all of that. And for the most part, I'm just going to gloss over the fact that it works and just say it works by magic. And what that means or what that implies is, look, these slides are available for you to look up. You can go to the actual links, which are here down at the bottom. And you know, certainly we can go over this stuff in more time. We are happy to do that, but I don't think it's worth glossing, going into a full deep dive on all of the elements here. I would also say that this will be a mix of technical and creative today. And we will talk about some clinical stuff, and we will talk about, we're gonna live code for most of this session. Where informatics can absolutely play a role is in that blend between the tech, the health system, and the care that is here. And while not all informaticians are technical or able to code, absolutely, they can help translate amongst these various fields and these various disciplines. And I think that's really wonderful. This is for the people that are here that are interested at Atrium. This is all in support of and thanks to Ying Ding's AI Health Data Challenge. It's a part of the AI Health course. There's some bit.ly links that you can follow that you can actually get access to. And you know, we can collaborate together on this because I really think that this should, and it's a wonderful opportunity for those that are multidisciplinary. All of the slides are available here at bit.ly/AI_health slides and the GitHub code that I'm gonna make, you'll be able to access that there as well. Any questions thus far, or at least from what I've covered? No? Cool. Okay. So I'm gonna cover four parts. I'm gonna explain the what and why of Flutter, why it's cool. I'm gonna give some very, very basic descriptions and show you in real time how we can work with widgets. And then we're gonna work with multiple widgets together as lists. And then finally, we're gonna talk about how you can store the data, and if time allows, we'll also connect everything to a cloud backend. So there's really four parts, and I think the majority of the time spent coding is gonna be in the Flutter 102 section. So what is Flutter and why? Well, Flutter is officially Google's portable UI toolkit. This is their logo, and for some people, they don't realize this immediately. This is an F. Took my wife a little while to figure that out. Flutter is built on the programming language called Dart. Dart has been around for about 8 years. Flutter is about 13 months old since it went live. It's very young, it's only a year. Dart, I'm gonna give a little deep dive officially, or at least from some of the articles that I've read. I love this term. It's an object-oriented, class-defined, garbage-collected language using a C-style syntax that transcompiles optionally into JavaScript. So it's fast, it's quick, and it can change into JavaScript. Magic. We'll just leave it as that. Over this year that Flutter has been around, Flutter has propelled Dart into the limelight. And as of last year, all of 2019, Dart became GitHub's fastest growing language. That's incredible. For a language that officially came out 1 month before, that's amazing. And there's a really good reason. And Flutter has four tenants, and they've kept this tenant since they've been live. They like making things that are beautiful, so they follow this process of material design. The app itself runs fast, and you'll get about 60 frames a second, even on older Android and iPhones, which is really cool. They designed this whole process to make you, as the developer, more productive. And hot reload is something I'll cover, but it's easier to show. And the entire toolkit is open source. So if you really want to dig into the weeds and understand how each of these elements works, you can. So I love this XKCD comic. Oftentimes, when you are building something and doing primary development and you press code or you press compile, it takes forever. And you'll see some of that in real time. Hot reload essentially nullifies this. And I used to give multiple various blogs as to why Flutter is amazing, but last month Codemagic had one very good blog, and I'm gonna use some of this, the images from there, but the points remain. If you're thinking of a native code. So if you're building something in iOS or something in Android, in iOS, you're going to be writing in Swift. Android, it's going to be Java or Kotlin. That code is what allows you to immediately draw whatever you want. And there's a lot of benefits to using a native code base. The disadvantage is if you're building for both, you have to keep both code bases going. React Native, Xamarin, and other similar single code base tools are pretty similarly aligned in that you write in whatever language you know, and then there's a bridge that accesses the original OEM widgets. And if you ever wonder why it looks just a little bit off, or you're not really quite sure, you know, it's a little slow, it's because this bridge is usually the bottleneck. Flutter doesn't have that. It does all of its rendering of widgets on its own. And that's what allows that 60 frames a second. That's why it's so fast. So you just write in Dart, and then you see it happen immediately. It is a declarative UI. And I could describe this as UI as a function of state, but I think I'm going to imply another magic here. You turn on the car and it runs. You start with the widgets that says, hey, this is what I want. And Flutter just says, okay, we'll put all that stuff together on the back end. So you're essentially using each of these various widgets as building blocks to build the UI that you want. And then it just works. That's really cool. That's a different style of thinking when you're making apps. And this style that Flutter specifically uses is going to be the UI element of Fuchsia whenever that comes out. Fuchsia is Google's upcoming operating system, also built on Dart. And to my knowledge, the two biggest things that harness Dart right now are only Flutter and Fuchsia. So if we were to get started, and I was to give you just one single slide cheat sheet, it's this one. Dart.dev and Flutter.dev, their own websites are extremely well worded, to give really clean examples for all levels of technical background. If you're a more visual learner and have $10 worth spending, I would strongly suggest the App Brewery's Complete Flutter Development Bootcamp. Also takes a very good perspective from a very basic and covers a lot of content. It was developed in collaboration with Flutter. For the clinicians here, if you want some continuing credit, here pretty soon, the lectures that I created for AMIA will actually be available. You get some CME credit or similar from them. And if you're interested in some of the YouTube content, I would suggest starting with Fireship. They also have paid content on their website. It's more expensive, but very high quality. And Devify allows you, it's a speed coding. So they start with the user interface, and then they show you how they made it while sped up and just playing some music in the background. That's pretty cool.